Tavern Gamers.
We got AKA Tony, Hoffinator in the house, your boy Russ Dangerous, we're here.
And we got something a little different for everybody today, don't we there, Russ?
Yeah, something special. We got Supreme going against the hardest AI bot this game has. Supposedly it's unwinnable, unbeatable, it's the best of AI versus one of our best fighters. And it reminds me of an old classic Star Trek case where the guy had to basically choose between a scenario you couldn't win. It was an unwinnable scenario. I forget what it was called though.
It was that training. Remember, it was training. It was called Kobayashi.
There we go. That's right? The one.
And it was, yeah, it's unwinnable. Captain Kirk solved it. How did he solve it? He changed the fucking rules. If you know what? If it's unwinnable, you got to do something other than just
let's try it out.
So good on him.
Programming code, thereby changing the conditions of the test.
The test itself is a cheat, isn't it? I mean, you programmed it to be unwinnable.
Your argument precludes the possibility of a no-win scenario.
I don't believe in no-win scenarios.
Lieutenant, you are looking at the only Starfleet cadet who ever beat the no-win scenario.
On the test, sir, will you tell me what you did? I would really like to know.
Got a commendation for original thinking. I don't like to lose.
Then you never faced that situation.
I don't believe in the no-win scenario.
Alright, so man versus machine. We're gonna see how many times Supremes try to beat this. And again, I wouldn't be surprised if he's tried it over a dozen times or two dozen times and still lost, because it's unwinnable, right?
Yeah, you can't blame a guy, like, but good on him for trying. And there are the numbers. Wow, so we got 0 wins and 44 losses for Supreme with our Endurance AI bot, who will be Mr. T. 44 wins and 0 losses. Just to tell you, you know, how difficult this is, and to a you know, experienced boxer like Lord Supreme, so yeah, you know what, we're gonna see. Maybe 45 is gonna be the one that tilts the scales, and maybe he wins this one. You never know. What do you think?
They might have found a weakness in the machine's armor, as they say, right? A weak spot or some kind of programming glitch they've taken advantage of.
Look at the Terminators. Nobody thought you could kill the Terminator. Then they eventually did kill one and said, hey, you know what? These things can die.
Just need some hot lava and throw them in.
And this is, I think this is where he's actually allowing us to visually see the fight. So people don't think it's some rigged fight that with some, you know, intro fighter, but no, he's going against Mr. T, the cream of the crop right now. And again, 44-0, so it's going to be a battle.
All right, let's see how they start off.
It looks like he's even giving it to the AI right now. Supreme is in the zone. He just wants to go at Adam. Making his look around the gangster alley. Pretty intense place for a fight. And there he goes, Supreme starting off already, but then somehow gets put back on his heels.
It's fast paced for sure. I don't know if it's by rounds or just by who gets knocked down. Like, I don't know the rules on this. Maybe it's regular rules.
I would say maybe not, man. You're in the, you know, back alley, motherfucker. You know what I mean? Like, there might be no
backyard
fucking rules back
here.
You know, just whoever just goes down and doesn't come back up, in my opinion, would be something more appropriate for this. Nonetheless, Supreme just giving everything he's got right now. Just giving him everything. Look at Supreme there, Russ. Like, these flurry of punches, jab.
Oh, man, I'm worried, man. He's rocked a bit.
I don't know. Seems like Mr. T, there's something wrong with him there. And then now he receives a flurry of punches.
Well, it's back and forth.
And as everybody could already tell, though, obviously... Down he goes!
That was a quick recovery.
Yes, so...
Bots don't need to rest.
Now, let's see if this momentum just keeps going here with Supreme, and this takes us into round two.
Okay, so that answers that question.
Wow. All right. So, just coming in with a bang right now. Just lefts, rights, jabs. Oh, he's just getting everything on him right now.
I can't tell if it's more of a counter style Supreme's doing or just kind of a flurry.
And nonetheless, he gets put on his back, but without any time, he's right back up again. Wow, and that's one for one right now. And there he goes back on his heels, but comes back with another flurry of punches. He's not letting up Supreme whatsoever, and a little bit of a headache on that one, but still nothing as severe. Now, Mr. T looks like maybe he's kind of tiring out, but then actually maybe not, because then he comes back and puts
the disrespect to that.
Back up. He's coming back up. Now, let's see if he...
he's up.
Let's see if he comes back with his own, which he seems like he is doing at this moment.
He's a bat out of hell. He's ready. He's fighting hard for his dear life.
With the AI Mr. T-Bot, 44-0, and he is just... Oh, and he's taking it to round three.
Doesn't seem like there's any let-up on this bot. He's just coming full force.
Well, just imagine the endurance that you need to fight this. He has just been going at it for now three rounds. And he's just going hard, and he's still coming back. And down he goes.
One.
The tunnel. A lot deeper and a lot harder to get through. Does he make it? Will he make it? Can he make it?
He's there. He's there.
He is up. He is up. And he is going once again at him.
Oh, nice body shot there.
Getting some shots right off the chin. That would usually make a normal man go down right off the first punch. And down he goes. Down he goes. What is going on here? Supreme just not having any of it. He wants more. Give him more blood. And that might be the end of the blood there. And he is down by knockout.
That is one tough fucking bot, folks. If you guys think you can do better, then try it out. But, he went, four or five rounds or something with him toe-to-toe?
That was round four.
This bot's a machine. He's a killer. What a pace. He's not sparing nobody.
And here we go. Wise Guy versus Michael Fury. Let's not forget, this coming Friday.
This is their promo song, so let's just let the crowd have a little taste.
I know I'd go from rags to riches.
This is Tino Gambino. Capisce? Listen, my VR boxer Wise Guy is going to show the VBF how to really put on a show. And to Michael Fury's manager, Chris, hey, just stay in your lane as the biggest VBF fan. Let the real virtual boxing managers do their fucking job. See you on Friday, fanboy.
I know I'd go from rags to riches if you would only say you care.
Yeah, we got Hoffinator in the house and Dangerous from Tavern Gamers. We're watching Michael Fury versus Wise Guy.
Another fantastic matchup, Russ. I've been watching these guys fight. Michael Fury, which, by the way, we're only going to be seeing in his view today because of the technical difficulties we are experiencing. So bear on with us while we get through these working pains. And here and they go already, Russ. Not even finished my sentence.
And I didn't finish my drink.
Punches. Yeah, exactly. Now, what is... And another kind of on his heels there. And another one. Wow. Okay, this is starting off quite heated there, Russ.
Are we in round seven or round one? What the fuck's going on here? Like, these guys are not holding anything back.
You know what? This is going to be... You know what? Oh, and into round two. You know... Even though they're going at it quite hard, you know, this, I can't see this going anything past 6-7 rounds, the way these guys are punching.
Yeah, this is nuts. The pace is crazy. Someone is already getting knocked down. Like, what the fuck is going on? I haven't even finished my second beer yet. What the fuck? Round three.
Yeah, I know. We're going to have to try to improvise. Maybe start to get some Tavern Gamers straws so we can just have it right by our mouths whenever we need it. We just take a sip. So, and back to the fight.
There we go. We got Michael Fury. It looks like he's kind of looping around like Muhammad Ali over here. He's blocking some low punches, throwing some little fakes, and I see some body shots over here. I haven't really seen that for most fights on the body.
The punches to the ribs.
To the ribs, yeah, body shots.
Yeah, yeah. And here we go. And I got to agree with you, what you're saying there on that last round there. I've been seeing a lot more body shots here by Michael Fury. Something, maybe a new tactic. What's the idea behind it? I don't know, but it actually does look like it is quite effective here.
We're slowing a wise guy down, it seems. But we don't know how these body shots translate in the game versus in like real boxing. We got to see how it plays out. No one's ever done the strategy before. So,
yeah, I can't say I've seen it yet in the VBF. This will be another first for me as well. It's good to see what's going to happen. And that takes us into round five.
Yeah.
All right.
Wow.
And once again, Michael Fury going for the midsection there. Five rounds. Yet, wise guy doesn't seem like he's really, you know, laying back at all. He's still coming at Michael Fury quite aggressively.
Oh, a few good overhand rights. He missed like three. And then a little body shot to kiss it
and
off.
There were some body shots. Yeah, he's going to the head. All right, so he's mixing it up, apparently, from quite different than what we're seeing here in Michael Fury. And wise guy. And, oh, saved by the bell. We're going into round six.
All right, let's see what they got for each other here. We're in the thick of things here.
Yeah, it looks like Michael Fury.
No taunting. You taunt, you're going to get sucker punched.
And wise guy is down.
What the fuck? He goes what? Down.
And
he's back
happened?
Up. What?
Did he go down or did he not go
down? I think
down?
He sucked off the ref, to be honest.
Someone checked his back for a spring or something.
Something happened there. I don't know what the fuck happened there.
What is going on here today? Now, we're now at, you know, the next round, and it looks like it's going the distance so far.
It gives me like those feelings of that throwback, that old school movie with Jean-Claude, you know, where the opponent was taking some like heavy fucking drug so he didn't feel the pain. I don't remember what drug it was. He just couldn't be stopped. That's kind of, I get the same vibes here.
You're not talking like Bloodsport at all.
I don't know if it was like Bloodsport, but it was one of those old school like retro fighter things. Stop here. Like, look at this fucking shit.
What is happening with these body shots? You know, maybe I was kind of guessing maybe he'd maybe try to change his strategy coming up to the late part of this fight, but looks like he's still going with it.
Oh, Fury is down.
What just happened there? Now, that I didn't expect.
He got caught. Tony got caught with his pants down.
And you know what happens when that happens?
You get bent over and sent to the ropes.
That's it. Just don't drop the soap.
That's
that
right.
Takes us into the...
And he's back
happened?
Up. What?
Did he go down or did he not go down?
I think he sucked off the ref, to be honest.
Someone
like,
checked his back for a spring or something.
Something happened there. I don't know what the fuck happened there.
What is going on here today? Now, we're now at, you know, the next round, and it looks like it's going the distance so far.
It gives me like those feelings of that throwback, that old school movie with Jean-Claude, you know, where the opponent was taking some like heavy fucking drug so he didn't feel the pain. I don't remember what drug it was. He just couldn't be stopped. That's kind of, I get the same vibes
you're not
here.
You're talking like Bloodsport at all.
I don't know if it was like Bloodsport, but it was one of those old school like retro fighter things. don't stop here. Like, look at this fucking shit.
What is happening with these body shots? You know, maybe I was kind of guessing maybe he'd maybe try to change his strategy coming up to the late part of this fight, but looks like he's still going with it.
Oh, Fury is down.
What just happened there? Now, that I didn't expect.
He got caught. Tony got caught with his pants down.
And you know what happens when that happens?
You get bent over and sent to the ropes.
That's it. Just don't drop the soap. Takes us into the ninth round here.
I think we're going the distance, man. This is ninth round. Have we ever seen this before?
I was good. I did, as you we heard it, you know, or as I mentioned at the beginning of the fight there, I didn't see this getting past maybe six. And it looks like we're well beyond that. These guys have the endurance of well-bred thoroughbreds just going at it like animals. So, and looks like Wise Guy still throwing it. Doesn't seem like he's been affected throughout this whole fight yet.
Wow, round 10. So I don't know if this is slowing the fight down, these body shots in the rib for Michael Fury. I don't know if Wise Guy...
The Metaverse has another treat coming its way after they see this fight, that's for sure.
He's and just doing a fury of combos over here, and then he gets knocked the fuck down.
I see. What? So that, again, it caught me off guard, and yet Wise Guy gets up again pretty darn quick.
Round 11. Wow, folks. I'm shitting my pants. Someone get me a fucking diaper, please, guys. This is insane.
This is war now. This is complete war. These guys are in the 11th round, and Michael Fury sticking with her in the 11th round. And Michael Fury sticking with his plan since day one, or round one, and that those furious body shots. Wise Guy just taking him in and coming back with his combos, hooks, punches to the face. This is just phenomenal. This is war, ladies and gentlemen. These guys are not fighters anymore. These guys are at war. Look, and is dropping him. Russell, what is happening? And
I wish I had an answer. He's down, but like, it seems like a lot more fighting in the clinch here. Again, another fight, a different style, more of the body punches from Michael Fury. I'm seeing a lot of more clinch fighting, not so much from distance.
And Wise Guy is a little slower that time coming up. I don't know, there is.
Okay. Oh!
He got the power of the Russell and got himself knocked out.
You get the fuck up and finish this, Michael Fury. Don't...
Oh, by knockout.
What?
By knockout. Let's look at these stats, ladies and gentlemen.
We got to see that again if we can, but holy shit, what a fight. This was a very tactical fight.
Phenomenal fight. I didn't expect that at all whatsoever. Well done. Great fight. And once again, thanks to everybody, Tavern Gamers.
Let's see that again. That was just a jab, jab, punch, combo, pop, chop. And I think it was maybe a hit in the fucking chin, and then he went the fuck out.
Yeah, you know what? There was just such a flurry of punches that were coming. It's hard to keep track. But at the end of the day, we know who won. Well done.
Michael Fury. Oh, sorry. Oh, that was a good body punch.
Yeah, right under the nipple. And it looked like we're getting this in slow-mo at the moment here. We can see that shot just clip him on the side of the chin.
I think they both hit each other at the same time, but there's just a Wise Guy just fucking still standing. Mm-hmm.
It's like Rocky when him and they hit each other at the same time. Bam!
Knockout.
Victory by knockout.
Wow. The scorecard tells a different fucking story here. Look at the... It's like one-sided, but then fucking...
That just goes to show you, this is VBF boxing. This is not your average day of boxing here, ladies and gentlemen. You fight and win from the depths of your soul.
From the depths of hell.
Depths of hell.